Put your hands together and help me welcome Mr. and Mrs. Jim Brennan. Who will now grace us with their first dance? Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause. If we could have everyone take a seat, we are going to serve dinner. The head table will be released first, and then someone will...
All times, and someone to look up to. I got to watch her learn from her mistakes, achieve great success, and have someone whose jokes and humor were always a few steps ahead of mine. If you haven't had the chance to get to know Kelly, I'll shed a little bit of light on the really beautiful woman that she is. Kelly has this contagious silliness and energy that make others just want to be around her. Her sincerity is incredibly endearing, and this, paired with her servant heart, make her the perfect hostess at all times. She pours out all that she has to others to make sure that everyone is having a great time, which you've probably noticed tonight, and I'm sure she'll ask you if you're having fun, which we all are, don't worry, Kelly. But my favorite thing about Kelly is the depth with which she loves. Kelly will stop at nothing to give to her friends and family. She's one of the most thoughtful people that I know, and it's made evident and all that she does with great love and sincerity. When Kelly introduced us to Jim, we immediately fell in love with his charm. So when everyone asked me what I thought about Jim and if I thought he was right for Kelly, I would always say, well, Jim's the perfect mix of Chris Farley and Will Ferrell. I've gotten to watch this life of the party bring a new level of joy to Kelly's life. Jim's playful personality is truly just the right balance for my sister. Jim, you have an ability to diffuse her frustration, and I've seen Kelly reach a new level of patience and love and forgiveness that I've never seen before she met you. At Jim, how you strengthen Kelly. And it's in the quiet moments that I'm most aware of how you two deeply love each other. I've seen Jim quietly stand beside my sister in moments of immense heartache, and I'm so thankful for the way that you're her rock and stability. So Jim, it's an honor to welcome you to our family tonight. And on behalf of myself and all of our family dispersed to tables throughout the room, I apologize now for what you signed up for. If you've noticed on the tables, Kelly has these quotes about love, and one that really caught my eye was from Elizabeth Browning, and it reads, "Love doesn't make the world go round, it's what makes the ride worthwhile." So Kelly, tonight I'm thrilled Jim is your new partner going forward on this ride. I love you both. Cheers to the new Mr. and Mrs. Brennan.
First.
In fact, I woke up this morning, took a brief shower, and on the flight down, I wrote a little bit of a speech for Jim, typed it up on my laptop and printed when we got here, left it on my nightstand, get out of the shower, we got our dogs in the room, and this is what's left of my speech. I thought I'd leave it behind a little memento. You know, God works in mysterious ways, and we got rained out of golf today, so that came in handy. I was able to write something a little bit else. I want to start the night out by just saying, Kelly, you look absolutely beautiful tonight.
Yeah!
You're absolutely beautiful. It's just great seeing you all here tonight. You know, your glow is actually wearing off on Jim. He's looking a little beautiful. But it's a real honor for me to be here tonight with Jim and Kelly and everyone. I'm used to seeing everybody here in flip-flops and a t-shirt, at least from the Lake Norman crowd.
Yeah!
Some of you feel pretty well. But I've been teasing Jim a little bit. In fact, I called him on my way down from Detroit this week and told him I'm doing something I never thought I'd do. And a lot of you may have had that same feeling as you got in your car. So I called Jim, I'm like, Jim, I got a real strange feeling about me, really kind of weirded out. He said, well, what's going on, man? I said, I'm heading your way. And most of us, I go back with Jim alone.